Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I am Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer. And if you've ever received one of those super annoying spam text messages on your iPhone, and you've wondered, what are you supposed to do about it? How do you eliminate them? How do you prevent them? Then this lesson today is just for you. We've all been there. You're working on your iPhone, minding your own business, when out of nowhere you get a text message from a contact you don't know. Maybe they claim they're from Amazon, or maybe they're advertising sunglasses, or maybe it's some sort of inappropriate message or inappropriate photograph. And the worst kind is when it's part of a group chat. And then the first message comes in, and then all the other people in the group message, people you don't know, start responding. They start saying, stop, don't text me, who are you, why am I getting this? And it's so frustrating and so annoying, and most people don't have any idea how to prevent it and how to respond to it. So today we're going to talk about both those things. The first thing you need to understand is that there are more than one kind of spam text message that we can get on our phones. One kind of spam message comes from a legitimate company. They're trying to sell you something. They're trying to advertise to you. Maybe you even opted in on a website. For those kind of spam messages, it's really simple. You just reply with the word stop. If they're a legitimate company, that's it. You'll be taken off their list. But what if it's not a legitimate company? What if it's somebody pretending to be Amazon? What if it's somebody who's asking you about some real estate property they think you're involved in or trying to talk to you as if they know you? And then the last kind of text message, which is the most frustrating, is one that's a group text message where somebody chimes in with something inappropriate usually, and then 10, 15, 20 other people get involved trying to get that first person to stop sending messages. And all those people are doing is making the situation worse. So the first thing is prevention. Apple has put some tools on your phone to help you filter and screen unknown text messages. So let's head over onto the phone and into the settings section to take a look at where that setting is. First, I'm going to go into settings. And then within settings, let's scroll down until we get to messages right here. Within messages, let's scroll down a little bit to where we see unknown and spam. And let's click on that. Now over here at the top, you're going to notice something that's called message filtering, and you can simply turn that on and that will immediately start to filter your messages. What does that look like? Let's go over to the text program and take a look. With this turned on, in the upper left corner, you're going to see a new option called filters. And if we click over there, we can choose whether we want to see all messages, only messages from known senders, or any messages from unknown senders. Generally, these kind of spam messages are going to show up in the unknown senders file. So that's the first thing you can do to prevent yourself from getting these messages. But there's another solution beyond Apple's filters. I use a third-party program called Robokiller. Robokiller is a fantastic program that not only helps with spam text messages, but also can eliminate robocalls that you're receiving to your phone. It's a subscription-based app, but I recommend it to all my clients and I consider it really valuable, completely worth the money. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on here. And within Robokiller, down at the bottom right, you'll notice the settings section. And within the settings section, there's a place called SMS protection. Let's click on that. And let's click to set it up right here. Now I'm going to have to go into the phone settings to make this change. So I'll go ahead and hit the phone settings button here. Now that I've done that, I can turn the Robokiller SMS filtering on. I'm going to go ahead and enable it. So with the spam filtering turned on through Robokiller, we get some additional options. I'm going to go back into the text messaging program and click on the filters in the upper left again. You're going to notice in addition to the top options, I've also got transactions, promotions, and junk. This is Robokiller's attempt to filter the different kinds of spam messages, things that are purchases that you've made, things that are promotional opportunities, and things that are just plain junk. So that's the first step to start to eliminate some of these text messages. But there's another step that we need to do. In addition to preventing them by using Robokiller, by responding stop to legitimate ones, we also need to protect ourselves and prevent the people that are sending us texts from doing it in the future. So if it's a single individual, not a group message, what you can do is you can click on the message, Go up to the top where it shows the name, click Info, and then Info again, and at the bottom, you can block that caller. That means that person will not be able to call or text ever again, just like that. But things are a little different when you get sent a group text. First, you're going to click on the initial text you received. This is one I got earlier today. First thing you're going to do is click where it says 20 people at the top, and then click on the I. This is going to show you a list of everybody that's in this group. When you click the Show More button, it shows the rest of them. If it's more than 10 people, it's definitely being sent through iMessage, not through standard text messaging. So you're going to scroll all the way to the bottom, and you're usually going to see an email address. When you see that email address, the first thing you want to do is click on that and block that caller. That's going to prevent that person from responding to you anymore. And then click your back arrow on the upper left corner here. And then at the bottom, you want to click where it says Hide Alerts. That means if anybody else responds to this text, it won't alert you, so we can address it one at a time. Now, I'm going to click the Done button here, and the last thing you want to do, you'll see here where it says Report All Messages. If you don't have Robokiller installed, the Report All Messages will report them directly to Apple, but if you have Robokiller installed, it will add it to its database of spam senders. So I'm going to go ahead and click Report All Messages. And then right here, I can add a category or give any other information, or I can click the Done button. I'm just going to click the Done button. All right, they've been reported, they've been blocked. Now the last thing you want to do is delete. So I'm going to come in here, I'm going to delete this one. And you'll see there are a couple of additional responses to this initial text message that came as separate messages because obviously they were responding from an Android phone. So I'm going to swipe here and delete that one and delete that one. You generally don't need to block the additional messages. Just go ahead and delete them because you already blocked the initial offender and that cleaned things up. So if you take those steps, either replying stop when you get something from a legitimate company, turning the filter on in settings messages, or downloading and installing Robokiller and following the steps that I just showed, you'll eliminate that message, you'll prevent it in the future, and you'll be able to go about your business and use your phone safely. I'm Dylan Stewart. I'm the Mac Whisperer. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up so that other people can easily find it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now's your chance. Go ahead and click that notify bell so that you always get alerted when I post new videos. We post videos regularly on all sorts of topics about Apple products. It's my purpose to help you get more done in less time and with less effort on your Apple products than you ever dreamed possible. I'll see you next time.